The Museum of Maria Skłodowska Curie in Warsaw, Poland is devoted to her life and work and is a biographical museum. The Polish two-time Nobel winner was born in this 18th century apartment building on Freta Street 16. The museum, which is sponsored by the Polish Chemical Society, is the only biographical museum in the world devoted to the discoverer of polonium and radium. The Maria Skłodowska Curie Museum was established in 1967 by the Polish Chemical Society. Participants in the museum's inauguration included the younger daughter and biographer of Maria Skłodowska Curie. The building has been rebuilt several times. After Maria Skłodowska Curie's death in 1934, a plaque was attached to the building, commemorating her birth there and her epochal scientific discoveries. During the 1944 Warsaw Uprising, the building was deliberately demolished by the German forces, but the plaque survived and was put back after the building was rebuilt after World War II.
Welcome again to another episode of Poland Daily Culture. My second guest will be Mr. Sławomir Paszkiet, and we will be talking about the history of the museum.
What were the most interesting temporary exhibitions shown here?
Takich bardziej rozpoznawanych wśród ludzi odwiedzających.
Wystawy czasowe, jedna z takich ciekawszych wystaw, które ostatnio były, to była Maria Skłodowska i Niepodległość. Oczywiście była to wystawa związana z odzyskaniem, setną rocznicą odzyskania niepodległości.
One of the more interesting exhibitions we recently had was the Maria Skłodowska Independence Exhibition, connected with the centenary of Poland regaining freedom, which we celebrated last year. Many people may not know this, but Maria Skłodowska Curie, apart from discovering radium and polonium and winning two Nobel Prizes, strived to make the independent Poland a greater nation, to preserve and make full use of the freedom Poland got back. With this exhibition, we showed that even before the independence was fought back, Maria was already preparing Polish science teams for their future work after the war. She invested her own money in Polish science, and she sent for promising young scientists to study under her in Paris. They worked on new scientific inventions. Her sisters fought for women's voting rights as well. Her older sister, Helena Skłodowska-Szalaj, was part of a committee which you could say won the voting rights for women in Poland.
Brała udział w komitecie, który, no, można powiedzieć, dla Polek wywalczył głos, możliwość oddawania głosu. Co ważne, Maria Skłodowska-Curie.
What's important, Maria always backed her sisters in their cause, either with a good word or with money, which was very important since the authorities cared very much about her opinion. She knew a lot of people, Polish presidents, politicians, musicians, writers, etc. A lot of them would later become one of the most influential people in Poland, and she met all of them in Paris.
Najważniejszymi politykami polskimi.
You must know some interesting stories from Maria's life. Could you tell us some of them?
Pan podzielić?
Wydaliśmy ostatnio wspomnienia Heleny Skłodowskiej, Szalaj, o Marii.
We recently published Helena's memoirs about Maria. In the first edition, there were some missing stories, probably censored by the communists. One such story concerns one of Maria's visits to Warsaw in the 1920s. Every time she came to the capital, she was welcomed with great reception, and this was the case here as well. In Hotel Bristol, in the Raspberry Hall, there was a great ceremony for her with around 20 speeches. During these speeches, which were very long and tiring for Maria, who wasn't in top health at the time, she was constantly writing something in the notebook she almost never parted with. It must have looked for the guests who gave her the speeches that she was writing up some of their quotes, and they must have felt good and important. After the ceremony, her sister Helena, who often co-organized these events, asked her how did Maria pull through the ceremony and why was she so happy at the end. Maria responded, "You know, I didn't pay much attention to what they were saying, but I was trying to solve a very difficult mathematical task, and I managed to solve it by the end."
A ponieważ na końcu udało mi się je rozwiązać, stąd byłam taka z siebie zadowolona.
Dziękuję bardzo za rozmowę.
Thank you for talking to me.
Hello and welcome. Thank you for joining us today. So we're in the actual house where Maria Skłodowska Curie was born. What is the history behind her life and when exactly was she born?
She was born here on 7th of November of 1867. And here in this house there was a boarding school located that Marie's mother, Marianna de Domobogusca Skłodowska, was the director. Both Marie's parents were teachers. As I said, her mother was a director, the owner of the finishing school for girls, and her father was a professor of maths and physics. He was also a vice director of one of the gymnasium here in Warsaw. After about a year, the family moved from here. Both parents of Maria belonged to the Warsawian intelligentsia, so the ideas they shared were very similar to Mary as well. She was an extremely gifted child. She learned to read when she was about 4 years old. Her formal education started when she was about 10 years old at the finishing school of Mrs. Jadwiga Sikorska. And after a year, her father, Władysław Skłodowski, decided to transfer Mary to the governmental school. And it was a rather hard experience for this little girl because she lost her mother a year before. Marianna died on tuberculosis. And the school was very oppressive to Polish children. Nevertheless, Mary finished this school with a golden medal in 1883. While she was less than 16 years old. And then for a year she was just resting. It was the decision of her father. She visited the relatives of Skłodowski at the villages and properties at the Polish provincia. After her return to Warsaw, she started to study at illegal flying university. The name was, the university was named this way because the places where the lectures were given were constantly changed. She started to work professionally in 1886.
How old was she then?
As a governess. She was 19 then, as a governess. The money she earned, she sent to her sister Bronisława, who studied then in Paris. It was medical studies. And in her free time, during these years of governor work, Marie also took some time for her self-education and to teach rural children. When she finished Warsaw after 3.5 years, she one more time attended to Flying University, and at the same time she gave some private lessons. It was a very important period of her life because she got access to the laboratory, the physics laboratory of the Museum of Industry and Agriculture here on the Krakowskie Przedmieście 66. And she acquired a lot of knowledge in chemistry and chemical analysis in those times. And after many years, she was convinced that those years led her, in fact, to discover polonium and radium next. 1891, she left Poland and she went to France to start her study on Sorbonne. After 3 years in 1893, she was awarded with a Bachelor of Science in Physics as the first person among all that were examined there. And a year after, she received her second Bachelor in Maths. And she was second between the students.